This Formica rufa wood ant queen has laid her first brood in a burrow near the sea. Her nest is just on the outskirts of the beach, the perfect vantage point for scavenging hapless morsels washed in by the tide. At the moment, the tide is out, but it won't stay that way. The ants must make haste and stockpile what they can, while they can. There is food to be found all over the beach, but the wood ants must be cautious and choose their trails carefully. Tiger beetles frequent the higher ground, and they will make quick work of any wood ant that strays too close. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. The tide is coming in. Soon the lower levels of the beach will be flooded. Any ants caught in the surge will be washed out to sea. The colony is starving. There's not enough food to feed the new brood. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The water is rising quickly. The ants must head for higher ground. There are intruders in the nest. The tide has almost reached its highest point. The sands east of the nest are about to be completely flooded. The tide is in, and soon night will fall. As the temperature drops outside, nocturnal creatures begin to awaken. It would be wise for the roofer colony to stay underground, and hope that their nest remains hidden until the morning. Overground, nocturnal hermit crabs rule over the sands at night. These creatures are typically scavengers, searching for algae and carrion on the beach. But due to the unusual incursion of Formica rufa colonies into this area, this particular community of crabs has developed a taste for ant flesh. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. The tide is receding and a new day dawns. The hunters of the night return to the safety of the shadows, and the ants can begin to lay down new trails. The harvest must go on. A dead sardine has been washed up on the beach. This feast is too precious to pass up, but the smell will soon attract other scavengers. The ants will need to amass in great numbers to defend such a prize. The workers have done all they can to improve these food stores. There are other wood ants out here. They have also come to take advantage of the buffet provided by the sea. Territorial disputes will invariably favor the colony with the greater numbers. The ants have been spotted by Chichindala hybrida, the northern dune tiger beetle. With its long, slender legs, it's the king of speed on these intertidal flats. Its wide, carving jaws will slice effortlessly through squads of wood ants. It's going to take a monumental, unified effort to bring this beast down. The colony is starving. There's not enough food to feed the new brood. The tide is coming in. Soon the lower levels of the beach will be flooded. Any ants caught in the surge will be washed out to sea. The water is rising quickly. The ants must head for higher ground. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. The tide has almost reached its highest point. The sands east of the nest are about to be completely flooded. There is another creature roaming the sands tonight, Arctosa parita, the sand bear wolf spider. In the day, these spiders retreat to the shade provided by larger plants on the edge of the beach. But once the sun has gone, they are far more active and on the hunt for a midnight feast. As the sun rises over a new day, the tide recedes. The nocturnal creatures return to the shadows, and once again, the harvest must continue. The workers have done all they can to improve these food stores. The ants must fight. Thank you. huge tiger beetle has been defeated. There are many more of them, but this is a milestone moment for the colony. They cannot be bullied by sheer size alone. The battle has begun. The tide is coming in. Soon the lower levels of the beach will be flooded. Any ants caught in the surge will be washed out to sea. The water is rising quickly. The ants must head for higher ground. The tide has almost reached its highest point. The sands east of the nest are about to be completely flooded. The tide is in, and soon night will fall. As the temperature drops outside, nocturnal creatures begin to awaken. It would be wise for the roofer colony to stay underground and hope that their nest remains hidden until the morning. Thank you. As the ants grow in number, the local predators pose less and less of a danger. Eventually, they will be displaced from this area entirely. Despite the dangers of the beach, it seems this intrepid queen's gamble to establish her colony here has ultimately secured her success.